Welcome to my channel. My name is Vidya and I'm a content creator. Firstly, thank you all for your suggestions on my Instagram. In this video, I'm going to show you how I achieve consistent whites and proper white balance in my images. I hope you'll have something to learn from this video. And if you do, please do like this video and subscribe to my channel as I'll be sharing more such videos every now and then. And if you want to see more behind the scenes and more of my photographs, please do visit my Instagram. And so without any further delay, let's get into the video. I shoot mostly with the natural light available from my window. And so I prefer in-camera white balance setting using the photo setting menu and choose color temperature up to 5500 to match the daylight from the window. In today's setup, I'm using the white background and also the black foam coat to fill in the shadows. I begin by arranging the props in the table and then I will bring in the main dish. 45 degree angle is the most common angle for food photography. It allows us to show the front and surface of the dish as well as the sides. In the image, we can see the ingredients in the food much better way. Here, I'm sharing with you all how I edit my food photos in a light and airy style. I edit using the Lightroom app in my mobile. To achieve the consistent whites in my images, I always use S-curve and adjust the highlights and shadows so that it deepens the shadows and brightens the lighter portions of the image and really helping the image pop. Also, color panel has become one of my favorite in terms of experimenting with different colors to get the look and feel I wanted for my images. I'm not saying that you have to use only the color panel for the images, but it is simply one of the tools you can use to edit the images. With color mix, we can adjust the color in a limited part. For example, if the shadows are only red, you can reduce the red in the shadows through this color mix. Also, we can adjust the tones of the colors using the white balance as you are seeing in this edit. To make the image more dramatic, I adjust highlights, shadows, sometimes whites and blacks as shown in the edit here. If you have any questions regarding my process, you can comment down below so I'll answer, and see you in the next video.